Just to be there. Good morning, one and all. Am I audible? Give me a response. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, in my house, the power has gone, only 30% the battery is remaining. If it is, the session is ended, I'll rejoin the mobile phone. Okay, after that, we'll continue in my laptop. Okay, in the previous class, we discussed about design of the bevel gap, and we also solved the problems, some of the problems from the design of bevel gap, right? Now today we are going to discuss about the worm gauge. Yeah, what are worm gauge? Worm gauge are, it is a power, mechanical power transmission devices in which I transmit both motion and power between two neither parallel or non-intersecting shafts. Right? The worm gauge are the gauge which are transmit the motion and power between two neither and non-parallel shafts. But those not a transmit the two shafts are neither parallel or non intersecting, can you go for use? What type of gauge to use? So worm gauge, right? And worm gauge mainly used for having a reduction of high velocity reduction, is 60:1. As you know, the velocity ratio is what? It's a ratio of the speed of driver. So assume the pin is a driver, so the ratio of speed of driver to the speed of driven, right? So it's a high reduction in velocity ratio. 60:1 means 60:1. What it means? 60:1 means what it is? So 60:1 means what? Anyone please unmute yourself? Means if a pinion rotates 60 RPM or 60 rotation. The pinion rotates 60 rotation, the gear, the larger gear rotates how many rotation here? One rotation. That is the meaning of high velocity reduction. Right? These worm gears are mainly used for almost all turning instruments, lifts, cranes, right? In almost machine tools, etc. Right? Worm gears are the gears which are transmit both motion and power between two neither parallel or non-intersecting shafts. Then we go for this, what type of gears? Worm gears. And worm gears are mainly used for high velocity reduction in the motion, in the high velocity reduction of the person. Means if your driver rotates 60 RPM, the driven rotates how much? Only 1 minute. Yes, this is how it is construction. You can see the worm gear. The worm gear sometimes see that one shaft is, this is the axle of the shaft, the smaller gear is called as a worm. Another axis here is larger in gear, that is called as a worm wheel, right? The two shafts are neither parallel and non-intersecting. Yeah, and the gear which is here is a worm gear is not in the, but the teeth are not formed on the surface, not formed on the cylinder. It is what is called as a thread is called as the ellipse which is formed on the cylindrical surface, called as a thread. The worm is also called as a screw. The worm, that is called as a smaller in size of the gear, that worm is also called as a, it looks as a, what component is a screw, is a threaded component, right? The worm is also called as a screw. Another one is worm gear, that is a similar to the other gears. But it is, whatever the other top surface, you can see there is a front view of the worm and worm gear. So one axis here is the axis of the worm gear. Another axis of the worm gear is perpendicular to the tree. The those two shafts are neither parallel nor intersecting. Is an audible please check? An audible please check? Now, if you see the side wave, you can see that warm or screw can look as a cylindrical surface, and warm will look as a rectangular surface. Up this here, the concave shape. You can see here is a concave shape, right? So that is the difference between the crossed helical there and the warm and warm wave. Crossed helical gears also mainly used to transmit the motion power between two shafts. Those two shafts are neither parallel nor non-intersecting. Right? That is the crossed helical gear. But here, warm gears also transmit the motion power between two shafts are neither parallel nor intersecting. What is the difference here? Here is a curved shape, is a concave shape. The tip is formed on the concave surfaces. That's the main difference between the crossed helical gear and warm gear. Right? Next, what are the main advantages and disadvantages here? In the warm gear, you can see that it is a what type of contact here? It is a line contact. You can see that from the screw to the gear. It's a what type of contact here? Line gear. Due to line contact, what happens? There is a rubbing velocity is more. A sliding contact is more. When sliding contact is more, what happens? Due to friction, heat will generate. There is a more amount of heat will generate.